Charlie there, what is one of those agendas a part of 2030? It's not just banning private property, even private cars. They have invented up this lunatic scheme, which will come into force in 2023. Banning vehicles which run on petrol and diesel in favour of electrical vehicle at current stages, very expensive to purchase, very expensive to run, has a limited range, and the batteries are pretty dear to buy. Our not just our local economy or national economy and the global economy is based on this type of petrol economy. This transition is too brief. The technology for alternatives is not like has evolved. Only the first generation of cars came out. The only vehicle which can give you a decent range is a Tesla. That costs around about 40,000, 60,000 quid. I don't think many people will permit such vehicles of this class. Practically, this will have a heavy impact on society and economy as a whole, because we're based on that type of element, oil. Electric cars existed since last century with petrol cars, and also petrol cars was more advantage in running costs, availability of the fuel instead of electric car. But the technology of electric car hasn't changed that much, hasn't evolved. How about alternative like hydrogen cars? They say with 6 kilos of fuel chunk, you can do 800 kilometers. Hydrogen in nature, it's easy to find and even produced as well. And probably the technology of this will be a bit more cheaper and more reliable. Because with an electric car, it's heavy, you've got batteries. At home, you have to put the vehicle under charge for 12 hours. And if you're lucky enough to find a rapid charge, 30 minutes. Currently, the infrastructure where you are doesn't exist. These called charge points, which should produce petrol stations in the future, depending how it will go. Petrol, it's so common, so diffused in the world, and you can't make it disappear overnight or throughout the years and go for another source. This is another of those stupid socialist ideas, all in the name of ecology. Ecology is a scam. They blame, as I said, people of the world for polluting the world due to carbon issues and shit like that. It's the first 100 corporation companies in the world which are responsible for 70% of the world pollution. Not just atmospheric, land or even the sea. So, if we don't fight back, as we are passing through this pandemic, fighting back and stuff uprising, and start saying we don't accept this shit anymore, we're doomed.